I'm Stan Chalecki, Associate Dean of Research and Graduate Studies at the Hackensack Meridian School of Medicine, and I welcome you today to the Interprofessional Health Sciences Campus. In particular, we're in Building 123, a building that co-localizes three schools, School of Medicine, Seton Hall College of Nursing, and Seton Hall's School of Health and Medical Sciences. We take a holistic approach to healthcare, where the three schools and their students are working, learning, and researching together. The building is connected by a sky bridge to the Center for Discovery and Innovation, a research enterprise that houses three institutes, an Institute of Multiple Myeloma and Lymphoma, Institute of Restorative Medicine, and Cancer and Infectious Disease. And not only do those 100-plus scientists focus on that, they focus on the pandemic of our time, COVID-19. The building that I'm going to take you through today, that I'm very excited to show you, is a facility that was originally focused on research, but is now dedicated to our curriculum. Every room that you're about to see was renovated with our curriculum in mind. The goal this morning is to be able to take you through all of them. We're now in the IHS library, a facility which contains information commons where students can work together with access to computers and databases. But in addition, the facility has a series of study rooms where students can work independently, in small groups or in larger groups, in rooms that are all enabled technologically. The library works with all three schools here on campus. There's a librarian dedicated to the School of Medicine, to the College of Nursing, and to the School of Health and Medical Sciences. And they offer support for students, for faculty, and administrators. We're now on the second floor in our standardized patient suite. The idea here is that our student physician will enter these offices from one side. The standardized patient is awaiting them, and the encounter ensues. These rooms are equipped with authentic, functional equipment. The encounter is being recorded and monitored in a control room. What's happening there is that our facilitators, our clinicians, are watching the goings-on, monitoring the interaction, and providing feedback, sometimes in real time, certainly just as the session ends. The overview of the session is sent to the student. Students are in these clinical facilities not in year three or year two, but rather on day one. I'm standing now in our high fidelity simulation suite. If it looks like a nurse's station behind me, that's by design. Here's an opportunity for us to work interprofessionally. Student physicians, student physician assistants, and student nurses coming together to understand the process about how these various disciplines work together. The robots afford our students an opportunity to engage in very high stress situations, but in a very low risk environment. And as you might imagine, it sets the stage beautifully for our students ultimately when they work with real patients in hospital wards. We've arrived now in our anatomy facility. This is where our students have an opportunity to work with cadaver specimens, where they conduct dissections, where they view prosections, and they engage with faculty and other facilitators. Students have access to this facility 24 hours a day. It is also interprofessional in nature. Our faculty facilitators are able to demonstrate techniques employing specific technologies, including glasses that allows them to focus on a particular tendon, a particular vein, or other structure, and then port it onto screens that exist all throughout the room. We've arrived now in a large group active learning room, one of our classrooms. You'll note the room has tables that move, chairs that move to allow us to adjust the size of groups for when there are periods in which the students need to work together. The wall is collapsible. It's a very flexible space and technologically equipped to handle all of the requirements for medical school teaching. We've entered now into one of our learning studios. These facilities are designed for small group work. Students have an opportunity to work together. They can employ their screens. They can employ microphones. The screens are very, very interesting in that the material that they want ported onto the screen can be shared with the other screens as students work together. We've reached the end of our tour. I want to thank you for taking the time to visit with us. We are, as you might imagine, extremely proud of what we've built, both in terms of the physical plant here on campus, as well as our curriculum and our School of Medicine. You should be awfully proud of what you've accomplished and the fact that you've gotten to this point. I hope the School of Medicine impresses you as much as it impresses all of us, and I wish you all the very best going forward. Make the right decision for yourselves. And thank you very much, and look forward to seeing you again.